Nature can be both beautiful and unpredictable. Same goes for the ice that covers our 10,000 lakes. 1 minute you're upright, the next, your feet first into the freezing water. What now? You might think you know the answer, but when it really happens, you might not be as prepared as you imagine.
So when you break through the ice, there's a cold shock that kind of takes over real quick. And the thing that you need to do is to just get your bearings.
We teamed up with the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources to walk through the steps of a self-rescue with no equipment. Cameras to catch all the angles.
Anytime you are, Joe.
And one really brave soul willing to take a dunk in the drink. Again. And again. Before we get to it, let's dispel a myth. Yes, hypothermia is an issue, but you're more likely to drown first.
You're not gonna start experiencing the effects of hypothermia for 30 to 40 minutes after you've gone through the water. So you've got actually quite a bit of time, a lot more than you would think, before hypothermia becomes an issue. The real threat to you right away is gonna be drowning.
That's why the most important step is step one. Don't panic.
You've got about a minute of time to kind of think through what you're gonna do.
Take some time to get your wits about you. Your first instinct is going to be to panic and try and get yourself out as quick as possible. But if you're doing that, you're not going to be thinking about the further steps you need to do to get yourself out. You're going to want to make sure you turn around and go back to the ice you came from. That's a very important step. You know that ice was good enough to hold you at one point, so it's most likely going to be your strongest ice. Well, even if you don't think there's anyone around, yell out. Call for help.
Spread your arms out so you spread the weight out, and then just start kicking your feet.
He's got his upper body in his hands as much as he can get out on the ice. Ice that'll hold him. And he's gonna start kicking his legs up to get himself as horizontal as possible before he starts trying to pull himself up on the ice. He doesn't want to stand up right away because he could fall right back through, so he's gonna roll away from the hole in the direction you came from. And once you have rolled a significant distance away from the hole and you know you're on some good ice, you can come up to your hands and knees, crawl away from that area. And then once you're on some really solid ice, you can stand up again and begin to walk away.
Walk away. That's the whole point and the best ending to any.
That's hard work getting out of the ice.
Fall through the ice story.
Well, the DNR says there's a simple rule to remember if you fall through the ice called the 1-10-1 principle. You have 1 minute to get your breathing under control and get your wits about you. You have 10 minutes of meaningful movement where you'll realistically be able to get yourself out of the water. And then you have 1 hour of consciousness after going in. 1-10-1. Mm-hmm. Also, if anyone from the DNR is watching, they would be upset if I did not tell you the best thing to do, of course, is to have the proper equipment, right? So if you have a life vest and ice picks, it is amazing how much faster you are able to get out of the water. And to prove that, we have two videos side by side online that show Joe getting out of the water, both using the ice picks and then the self-rescue. And you can see just what a big difference it makes. And if you missed any of these steps, we of course have the video for
you
online.
That's a great story to be sharing online. I mean, there's really, really good, useful tips in there, but you can tell how hard it is to get out even with all those tips, so.
And I think people think they know what to do.
Right.
But I don't think you know what to do until it happens,
right.
So there you go.
Great, thank you so much, Rena.